Hi students, now let me start the module 1 in subject the design of manufacturing. We know components are getting manufactured. So in this subject we are going to see about what is the importance in design for the manufacturing. Okay, so in the total module we are going to cover these topics. One is introduction to design manufacturing, major phases of the design, effect of material properties of the design, and what are the materials to be used, and what are the guidelines for this manufacturability, and what is the relationship between the tolerance and the machining processes, the process capability index, what is process capability index, and some laws for the fitting this. Okay, now let me see one by one. One is the first one we are going to see about the introduction of manufacturing, right? So in this, first we should know what is a design. We know what is a manufacturing, so what is a design? Okay, these two are now it's very important for this topic. So manufacturing is the process through which raw material is transferred to the final product. Okay. The manufacturing process, it starts with the design first, and then we are going to make different process, and through the process finally you are completing the model and we are going to distribute for the customers. Okay, this is the manufacturing the process. Okay, then what is the design in that? Design means for your product we need a specification. So any product if you should take without any specification, the size, the shape, or the materials, we cannot do any product. Okay, so the meaning for it, what is a design? It is a plan for the construction of the object. Okay, so for any design, either it may be a product or anything, so design is very, very important. It's a plan, so we call it as design, as a plan for the process, right? So then what is design for manufacturing? Now we have seen about manufacturing and what is manufacture, what is a design. Then what is the design for manufacturing? The design for manufacturing is a practice of designing the products in such a way which is easy to manufacture. Okay, so I already said design is a plan, and plan for manufacturing, that's what, how easily we can manufacture the components. Okay, then what is the use of it? What the design will help in manufacturing means it reduces the manufacturing cost. Without any proper planning or without any designing, if you go for making a product, it's very difficult and it will increases the cost. But once if you get a proper design for the manufacturer, normally without designing the component cannot be produced. But here once the product is done, what is the feasibility to reduce the cost? What is the different analysis can be made for reducing the scrap? Okay, these are all the things which includes in the design. So there are so many things affects the manufacturing process. We know the tolerances and the type of materials. So whatever we are doing a component, we are selecting a product which is with the application. Okay, the product is made with the applications. The applications to get the applications, we need the material properties. If the material is having those suitable properties, then only it can be useful for this product, like that. And dimensional tolerances, we cannot make the product without any dimensions, and the dimensional tolerances is also very important. And the surface finishing, the surface roughness, these are all important for the design. So now why DFM is important for our product, that is it makes sure that the product can actually be manufactured. So whatever the product is, it gives the analysis. The DFM makes the analysis about the manufacturability, and it will make easy to manufacture this. So since it is doing the analysis doing in the production environment, it is 100% confirmed that it will give a good output. and it can affect the look, the precision and the function of the product. So the DFM consists of the bill of materials, the tolerances, okay, what are the methods to be followed and all the things. It will help to reduce the cost and give a good precision and function of the product. But normally it will affect the timeline, timeline means we have to work a lot, but surely it will help to increase the improve the product. Okay, so the final product and the benefits what we are going to get after the DFM process, it's very good. Later it will give the benefit only. Right, next we are going to see about the morphology of design in the next video.